In this video, let us study about the functions of the political parties. So there are basically seven functions of political parties. The first and the foremost function of the political parties are to contest elections. Now every party want to come to power, and for that they have to contest the elections. And parties contest elections by putting forward some candidates. Now these candidates fight election among each other, and these candidates are selected by the party on different basis. In USA and in many other countries, it is the supporters and the members who choose the candidates for standing in the election. But in India, it is the top leaders who choose the candidate to stand for the election. So the main function is to contest election. The second function of political party is it put forward different policies and programs. Now all of us know that different political parties have their own policies and programs. The government cannot incorporate the policies and programs of all the political parties. So that is why each political party or the government narrow down the vast multitude of opinions and vast multitude of policies into it narrows down into some basic principles, and each party will function according to those basic principles. And the party which wins the election and becomes the ruling party, so the government will function according to those basic policies of the ruling party. So vast multitude of opinions can be narrowed down to some basic principles, and according to that basic principles, the political party will run the country. The third function of political party is to make law. Now, making law is one of the function. So, whether it is ruling party or opposition party, the laws are debated with everybody before it becomes law. So, the matter is debated, and then only it is passed in the legislative assembly. Now since all parties, many parties are there in the legislative assembly, and all have their own leaders also, so usually personal opinion about the law does not matter. Instead of that, people support the party or the party leaders, and then laws are framed. Now the fourth function is parties form and run government. Now making law is the legislative function, and forming the government and running the government is the executive function of the government. Now the political party choose some leaders from their own parties. They train these leaders and make them ministers. And these ministers run the government according to the wish of the political party. So it is the political party which forms the ministry and runs the ministry. Some of the members of the political parties are also members of the executive who run the country. One more function of political party is it plays the role of the opposition. As we know, those political parties who could not win majority, they sit in the opposition and act as opposition party. They always keep check on the ruling party. They criticize the policies of the ruling party if it is not for the benefit of the people. So in that way, one role of political party is to oppose the ruling party. Then one more function of political party is it shape public opinion. Now these political parties are spread all over India. So in every area there may be some issues which have to be highlighted. So these political parties, they raise and highlight the issues of that particular region or that particular area. Mostly these groups of people who raise or highlight the issues, they are the extension of the political parties only. So they form a group and they form a pressure group. That means there may be different sections of the paper who want their work to be done by the government. So these political parties will help them in forming the pressure groups to put pressure on the government to get their work done. So there may be certain business groups, there may be some traders group, so who will pressurize the government to get their work done. And this is usually done by the political parties because they are shaping the public opinion by helping these pressure groups. Then movements, they also highlight these political parties also highlight the movements, maybe some environmental movement or women's movement. This is usually done by some political parties with the help of common people. They raise the issues and want to gain public support. So they shape the public opinion by highlighting the issues. Then the one more function of political party is access. Political parties are easy access to government machinery and welfare schemes. That means a common people would find it easy to approach a local leader than to approach a government official. These local leaders are easily approachable, so the people, common people, usually go with their problem to the local leaders, and these local leaders should always be accessible to the people, and they should be a bridge between the common people and the government. So if they act as a proper bridge and solve their problem, then people will be happy with this political parties and they will vote them for the next election also. Or otherwise, if these people are not accessible, the people will not vote them for the next election. So this group of people, that means the political party, is also easy access to government, whether it is ruling party or opposition party. They can easily access the government, so people approach the parties first. So these are the seven functions of the political parties. This question is usually asked in the board examination. Then before that, what we studied, key components of the political parties, the meaning of the political parties. These are some probable questions in the board examination.